Hey everybody, it's Data Kobe, and welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Street Jump Distance HD. In the last part, we returned back to Traverse Town, where we played as Riku, where we learned from Joshua that a certain Dream Eater is causing trouble, and so we decided, you know, to go help, you know, Joshua and his friends defeat this Dream Eater. But Joshua also mentioned some very, I guess, important stuff, but basically the two parallel worlds where they're two of the same thing. He's talking about, like, there's different time zones and something's not right, and it's like this is probably all a dream too, what Riku's experiencing, I don't know, but that's the thing about this game's plot. It just confuses you. It doesn't make sense. Why can't they just simplify things? I mean, I'm pretty sure some people will get the idea of what they're talking about, but I guess for most of us, we just don't know. We're just so confused. But hey, maybe you guys are not confused, but maybe it's just me. I don't know. Probably me. But anyway, so we, you know, made our way to the plaza. We saw Beat and his partner. And we also saw the Dream Eater, too, which is basically like a pelican bird on a broomstick. And he can, like, summon Dream Eaters, too, which we also dealt with. But unfortunately, he escaped, which kind of sucks. And, yeah, so basically that's it. Not much, really. For story-wise, basically, just find a certain Dream Eater and get rid of it, and that's it for the story of the world. Not very long, if I do say so. And yeah, so alright, let's see, before we go, can I get curious? Ooh, so close. I'll get you. And you. And you. Oh, hold on. Aw, not enough. Crap. Alright, that's fine. So I guess the only thing left to do now is just draw up, since, you know, we had to finish Traverse Town with Sora, then we'll go on from there. So let us drop. What to use? Let's do this one. Alright, let's get you and you. There we go. Yes. So yeah, we're back here on the grid. Now the reason I was at the grid here is because I was doing some grinding as Sora. And if I could show. As you can see, we're now level 26. But Riku, like, first started, he was like level 22, but then he catched up. And I think he's like around level 25? If that's correct. But yeah, so Riku's catching up with Sora here, so that's fine. Let's see. Anything? Oh, hold on. Let's use. Oh, let's do this one. Faraka. Yeah, that should be fine. Alright, onward. Back to Traverse Town. Nah, I'm not gonna die if I don't see a point to it, so let's just visit.
Traverse Town. Why, hello down there, Sora. I've been waiting.
For how long?
You do know you can wait on the ground, right? Come down so we can talk.
Now?
Now? What do you mean now? You're the one who said you were waiting.
You know, you're turning more into Neku every day. But listen, I'm glad you two showed up because...
You two? Does that mean Riku's here?
Yes, but you and he are still a world apart. He didn't seem especially worried, though. He knows he'll find you.
Yeah.
Just look at Neku. He and the others all found their game partners.
Oh, they're back home safe now?
Remember what I told you. Their existence is on the line. And the Reapers are dead set on erasing them for good. But they found refuge in this world. And luckily, each other too.
Reapers?
Yeah, what are they?
Right. If Neku and the others want to get back to where they came from, they need to win the Reapers' game. It's like a series of missions. Those are the rules of their home ground. Except, this time, the mission is a tough one. They're pitted against a Dream Eater that can summon 100 more like it. So, I was sort of hoping you and Riku could help us out. You have your Keyblades, and with those, we might still have a chance.
Well, I'm glad he's here with me.
If he is. Riku's on one side of the portal, and you're on the other. He might be by your side, he might be a million miles away. You can't measure the distance in time or space. Even without the wall between you, it's hard to say.
Don't worry. He's with me. Even when it might seem like he's not.
Then you two are lucky.
You and your friend are lucky too, Joshua.
I appreciate you saying that with conviction, even though you have no idea what you're talking about. Hey!
Nice one.
Anyway, Neku and his partner are pinned down in the Fountain Plaza. I can count on you, right?
Always.
I like you, Joshua. You're a funny guy. Even though I still don't know what you are. Even though you have, like, wings of an angel. I don't know if you're an angel from heaven or an angel from hell. I don't know what you are, dude. But yeah, so they mentioned the Reapers, which I'm pretty sure is the enemy in their, you know, video game, which is called The World Ends With You, which I still have not played, by the way, so I don't know if it's a good game or not, but I mean, it has to be if it's in this game. Because normally, they don't normally do, like, video game world characters. They normally do, like, you know, Disney World. It's not like video game characters. I mean, Final Fantasy makes sense since, you know, Disney and Final Fantasy is crossover. That makes sense, but in this case, for this game, they have, you know, Joshua, B, Neku, and Shiki, yes. From them, your respective games, so I think they're the first ones ever from a video game to be put in a Kingdom Hearts game. Because, like I said, they only focus on the Disney movies and not the actual video games themselves. So, I think they're the first ones to incorporate that in the Kingdom Hearts game. Quote me if I'm wrong. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's correct. Oh, jeez. Okay. Stupid elephant. That's right, get out of here. What? Who's left? Oh, you. Anything new? Maybe? No. I thought there'd be a chest somewhere, but I guess not. Huh. Oh, here we go. More chests. Oh, god damn it. It's a little trickster. I hate when they do that. They always trick you thinking, oh, it's real, but then they say, nope, screw you, I gotcha. Yeah. Well played. Well played indeed. So anyway, on a side note, starting tomorrow, at the time of this recording, is when Halo Wars 2 is coming out. And I did say last episode that when Halo Wars 2 comes out, I will be recording that game. And then once I finish off Halo Wars 2, then I'll go back to Kingdom Hearts. Because the reason I decided to do this is because, well, I played Dream Drop Distance before. I, you know the story and everything, but Halo Wars 2 is something new. It's a brand new Halo game. I never played it before. I mean, I played the betas since they released, but that's about it. So I apologize to you guys if you're hoping for more Kingdom Hearts videos. Until then, you know, my plans. I'm first gonna do Halo Wars 2 as soon as I get it. I'm gonna start do it from start to finish. Then I'll move back to Kingdom Hearts. So that's the plan. I mean, maybe I could do Halo Wars 2 one day and then Kingdom Hearts the next day and then go back and forth, but I just think to make things more simple for me, I'm just gonna do Halo Wars 2 first, then Kingdom Hearts. Just makes it a bit easier for me. But yeah, that's all I have to say regarding, you know, about the whole Halo Wars 2 Switch game situation. What is that? Is that a heal?
This is starting to wear me down. Can we get a timeout?
Oh, it's this guy again.
What? Miss me?
Sora?
I'll take it from here.
No. I don't need your help.
Of course you do. Where are your Dream Eaters? How else can you fight?
I don't need them anymore.
Oh, right. Your partner. Well, don't you want to make it out of the game? Who's gonna help her if you get hurt?
He has a point.
Okay, you win. I'll let you do the sweating.
Sure. I guess we'll do the hard work for you. But I don't think Sora minds. Alright, let's go. Come on. Careful. And I'm also sorry for not talking much. I'm just trying to concentrate. Oh, jeez. Ah, great. I'm stunned. Fantastic. What? How'd you dodge that? And how'd you dodge that? There we go. Finally. There we go. Ooh, sliding sidewinder.
He got away.
Sora.
So you must be Neku's partner.
Yeah, I'm Shiki. Nice to meet you. Neku told me all about you.
Cool. You should have seen him. He looked everywhere for you.
Hey, Sora, stop talking.
What? Why? You said you need her. That's a good thing.
That's sweet, Neku.
I need you to stop annoying me.
Mm-hmm. Well, I still
think I think so too.
It's nice to be needed.
I'm sorry, is this a bad time? Because that Dream Eater we're after has retreated to the other imagining of this world.
Other imagining? You mean where Riku is?
Yes. He and our other friends will do what they can, but we'll just run ourselves in circles at this rate. We need to trap that thing in one place, and then we can finish it.
Trap it where?
The third district.
Okay.
Joshua.
Yes, Neku?
Tell me, are we really gonna make it home?
But Neku, I thought you couldn't afford to lose. Give up on yourself, and you give up on the world.
Right. So I'll see you there?
Me?
Yeah. You're my friend. It's your home, too.
How nice of him.
Maybe it's you that's turning into Sora.
Huh?
Thanks.
See, they're very good friends. I like it.
Take this. Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Oh, crap. Now I can't see. Alright, we good? Wait, can we destroy these? Hold on. We angle this right and... Oh, would you look at that, a treasure chest. Oh, look, we're going back to the post office. We go.
Come on.
Oh boy.
Wait. Yeah. Yeah. Take this.
Oh my god, how could he shoot me from that far? That's crazy. So, actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna skip the enemies because. Well, actually, hold on. Oh, I'm so close to the next level up. Alright, maybe I'll do one more level up, then I'll skip the enemies. What? Oh my god. What is up with this guy?
Take this.
Get out of here. Oh, what? Whoa. That was crazy. Take this. There we go. Alright, we're done. We're leaving. Goodbye. No need to stick around anymore. Out of my way. I got stuff to do. Oh, is that him? Yep.
I got it, Riku.
It's working. People through for us.
We'll handle things here. You take care of the boss.
I like how he calls it the boss. Boss fight. Oh, God. Oh, not this stupid monkey again. Stupid monkey. I still hate you to this day. You were such an annoying boss fight when I first fought you. But thankfully, I have some new moves this time. So the fight shouldn't be too hard. Or it could be even harder. I don't know. Oh. Oh, yeah. Have fun. Whee! Uh-oh. Boxing gloves. One more. Oh, Jesus. Aha. You're lucky I can't touch you. That's cheating what you're doing. No! Ah, great. Okay, I think I see what's happening here. Apparently this guy's just gonna keep summoning the boss fights we fought before. Great, that's gonna be fun. Oh, jeez. Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, jeez. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Ah. Oh. That was too close. There we go. Alright, what else are you gonna summon, huh? Come on. Oh good, it's the crab thing. Fantastic. Man, three bosses at once? That's ridiculous. I mean, for Riku's, we just have to, you know, finish off those Triceratops 3 meters, but for Sora's story here, we're facing the same boss again. I don't know what's up with that. Oh, reality shift. Oh. Have fun. Whee! Boom. Uh-oh. Oh, crap. Well, actually, no. Now I think about it, I think this is the same guy from Riku's story. Because Sora's was like the ice one. I think this is Riku's version. Alright, this should finish you off. Goodbye and good riddance. Thank you. Jeez, three bosses at once? That's crazy. Whew, well, we managed to do it. Thank God. Coward.
Hey, Josh, where'd it go?
Somewhere else. Out of Traverse Town and out of my reach. We'll just have to let it go.
Great. That's what I said.
So we failed the mission?
I'll go after it.
What?
Come on, I'm not an actual player. Can't I bend the rules?
Well, I guess the rules of the world don't apply if your hearts are connected. Right, Sora? That's how you roll.
Right. Then it's settled.
Sora. Thanks. It wasn't easy. You made it easy.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Wow, Neku, you've changed.
Huh? You think?
Yeah. You're less dorky.
What?
Once you find your friend, Sora, you should come hang out in our town.
Definitely.
See you in Shibuya. Maybe Kingdom Hearts 3,
sure.
You might.
It's a deal.
It's a possibility. I mean, it would be kind of cool to see the world, since I never played their game before.
Anything I should pass on to Riku?
Nah. I'll see him soon.
And we got the Nut Punch Keyblade again. So overall, it was kind of... I like Sora's... I don't know, I kind of like both versions, but I think Sora's version of Traverse Town, like the Revisit, in my opinion, is a bit more better than Riku's, but they're still kind of fun, but I prefer Sora's story. Just my opinion. Oh, back here.
Thug works for me. We all got a role to play, right?
Gorsh, at least he's honest in a dishonest way.
Silence! No underling of mine shall be insulted so. I have great plans for dear Pete and for all the worlds. Once I have taken them for
Yeah, and how are you gonna do that?
Then I've got bad news for you. That day's never gonna come.
Perhaps you should take a few moments to reconsider. Or does the Queen's life mean nothing to you at all?
Mickey! Don't you listen to her! You can't let Maleficent have her way!
No! Minnie! All right, Maleficent. Tell us what you want.
Let me see. Shall I begin with this world? I much preferred it in its darker, more ominous permutation.
You said it! This
really? That's what you want, to take over this world again? Because the first time you failed, and you want to do it a second time?
You would go through this much trouble just for that. What is it you're
See, Mickey
really
knows
after?
That's not what you're really after.
Very perceptive. I presume you are familiar with Xehanort, the man who led me to discover worlds outside of my own.
You
know
him?
Yeah, she does.
As do you, I see. Yes, he shared everything with me. How to go about winning a heart over to the darkness. And, most gloriously, about the seven hearts of pure light. The ones that would grant me the power I need to conquer all worlds. However, the worlds were too complex. Too much for even me to contain. It seemed I had miscalculated. Then it came to me. Of course, I could go about conquering other worlds in my own manner. You do have the data for all the worlds, do you not? And now you will hand it over to me.
What do you mean?
Don't you bozos pretend you don't remember. Me and Maleficent was trapped inside it.
Oh, yes, recoded.
Why do you want the data?
I'm afraid that is no concern of yours.
Wouldn't want a royal Minnie Mouse in us to get a boo-boo now, would we?
I see you have failed to recognize the futility of your situation. Very well. Face your doom!
Uh-oh. Oh! Hey! Ooh, nice one.
Oh, Mickey!
Minnie! Maleficent, you lose!
Say, m'lady, I think the pipsqueak's right. We better hit the road.
I now know that what I seek lies within these walls. Trust that I will eliminate you in good
time. Yeah, we'll see about that.
Hey, wait for me, Maleficent. Wait!
You used the darkness to get here? That was reckless. But gosh, I didn't expect you to save us.
Hey!
Axel?
Mm-mm, it's not Axel.
Axel didn't. My name is Lee. Got it memorized.
Oh, yes. I mean, Axel's a cool name, but his real name is now Lee. Ooh. Trophy earned. Distinct worlds. Now we got a glossary. The Seven Princesses of Heart. Oh, yes. Recoded. And my opinion and everyone else's opinion, this story was kind of pointless. It didn't do much to advance the plot. It just did a recap and just, I don't know. Out of the whole series of games, Recoded is the worst story in my opinion because it's just pointless. I mean, sure, there is advance the plot a little bit. You know, all about, you know, those that Sora has to save, you know, and also explains what Mickey said in his letter to Sora at the end of Kingdom Hearts 2, but I guess also with, at the end of Recoded, we learned of Xehanort's return, but for the majority of the game, it's just worthless. There's no point. It's all for nothing. But anyway, I guess I'll read the Recoded Chronicle. And I think this is the last chronicle to read because, yeah, I think this is the last one because we got all of the games covered. So this is going to be the last one to read, guys. So let me get my voice ready so I can read. All right, here we go. Jiminy was surprised to find a mysterious message in one of his journals, which was supposed to be blank. Their hurting will be mended when you return to end it. To help better understand the message, King Mickey created a datascape from the worlds within the journal. But the datascape was riddled with bugs, and the king had to rely on the digital version of Sora to debug the journal from the inside. While exploring the Disney Islands datascape, a figure in a black coat explained that uncovering the keyholes was the only way to mend the worlds. Sora found the keyhole in Traverse Town, and use it to reach the next world. As he did, a new message appeared in the journal back at Disney Castle, and the king was alarmed to discover the castle had been invaded by Heartless. Worse yet, he and the others were now trapped in a library. Again, Sora came face to face with the figure in the black coat, and this time, when he followed the stranger, he found himself in the same room as King Mickey and the others. How had they wound up in the same place? The figure in the black coat turned out to be a digital version of Riku, who explained what was going on. He had been chosen by the journal as backup storage to protect its data. Now Riku and the journal were one and the same, and he had brought Mickey and the others into the datascape to help solve the mysterious message. Just then, someone took over the pathway between the datascape and the real world. There was no way out. Sora set off to repair the more worlds and secure a way home for his friends. It turned out Maleficent and her henchman, Pete, were the culprits. They were planning to release the darkness inside the Datascape into the real world. Sora tried to stop her, but she destroyed his Keyblade and kidnapped Riku. The king went after Riku, and Sora went after the king. Sora's friendship with Donald and Goofy gave him the power to recreate the Keyblade. Pete had infected Riku with bugs and tried to pit the two friends against each other, but after a short fight, the infected Riku collapsed. Sora dove into Riku's Datascape to save his friend, and defeated Maleficent inside. However, it wasn't until he took out his own Heartless, the original bug which was threatening to delete the whole Datascape, that the journal was finally restored. But because restoring the journal was tantamount to overwriting all recorded, or to overwriting all record of this newest journey, Data Sora and King Mickey had to say goodbye. However, the mysterious message was still a mystery. Back in the real world, King Mickey and the others received a message from Data Riku that extra data had been found. They would need Data Sora's help one last time. The extra data was a special world designed to make Sora learn how to cope with hurt. When Data Sora was finally ready to accept that hurt, Naminé appeared before him. She explained that inside him were special memories that belonged to people connected to the real Sora, people who were hurting. The mysterious message was her way of reaching out to him and preparing him for that truth. King Mickey promised Naminé that they would undo all the hurt. Back in the real world, he wrote a letter to the real Sora and explained there were others out there that only Sora could save. And yeah, like I said, the plot of this game is just pointless. It just doesn't advance the plot much. It's just kind of pointless in my opinion. Oh, hey, look at that. We have new worlds to explore. Nice. Now, here's something I want to mention about that cutscene. So remember when Maleficent mentioned that data that she wants? Well, if you watch the Recoded movie, they added the extra scene where Maleficent explains that, you know, she wants the Tome of Prophecy, which he explained is, if you have the Tome of Prophecy, then you can, like, summon worlds or, I guess, people or stuff like that. And if she had something like that, she would be very powerful. And apparently she needs the data in order to find the Tome of Prophecy. Which makes me think that if she's after that, in Kingdom Hearts 3, will she go after it and claim it? And then will Sora and Gang be in trouble? I don't know. It makes me think that she is... I'm just theorizing about, you know, what Maleficent's plan is. I mean, that's my theory, that she will find the Tome of Prophecy and, like, summon up maybe an army or something, or worlds for her to conquer. I don't know. Just a theory, right? I have... Alright, what new worlds do we have? Country of the Musketeers. Oh hey, so I guess this world is based off the Three Musketeers. As you can tell by the tips of the swords. And then Sympathy of Sorcery. This world is based on the world of Fantasia. In case you don't know. So yeah, we have the Three Musketeers and Fantasia. But once we beat these two, it looks like there's only one more world to explore and we're basically done the game. So I would say we're like halfway through the story already. And we just have like halfway more to go and we're done. Okay, so the Country Musketeers level is 26 for that, and specifically Sorcery 34, so it's obvious we're going to this one first, then we're going to this one. That's the plan, according to what the, you know, combat level says. Alright, so I guess that's the plan, guys. So, but unfortunately, this is where I'm going to have to end it right here, guys. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, be sure to leave a like and comment. And also, if you guys have any names for my spirits, be sure to post them down in the comments. Because I still have not got any names yet for my spirits. But if you guys do have any names, don't be shy. Put them down. I'll look them over, see if they're good or not. Oh yeah, I forgot. One more thing. Oh, we have more glossaries. Of course. Oh, we have a bit more stuff to read. What do we have? Oh, okay. So let's do character files first. We have Pete, an arrogant troublemaker who was plucked out of his timeout in Disney Town by none other than Maleficent. He has been her somewhat sidekick ever since. Queen Minnie, the queen of Disney Castle. Maleficent and Pete nabbed her while King Mickey was away. And last but not least, Maleficent, an evil fairy who wishes to see all worlds cast into darkness. She has clashed with more than one Keyblade wielder. This time, she tried to use Minnie as a bargaining chip and claim the data of all worlds. That's exactly what I said. Like, it seems like if she's gonna get the book, she needs the data of the worlds first. Which means she's gonna be a bit of a problem. Which means she might return to Disney Castle Kingdom Hearts 3, if that's the case. At least I think that's how it goes. Let's see. I guess I'll do glossary. The Seven Princesses. Another name for the Princesses of Heart, the only seven people in the world whose hearts are pure light. While not necessarily royalty, they are called princesses because they are all female, and the one who brings them together will reign over all worlds. The nature of the princess's power is not entirely clear, but once already their hearts have been stolen to create an entrance to Kingdom Hearts, and a so-called Keyblade of Heart. That wasn't very much long glossary, but that's fine. Oh yes, revisited. I guess we'll do Riku's first since we did Riku first, and then I guess we'll do Sora last, so let's see. Joshua was waiting when Riku arrived back in Traverse Town. He asked for help defeating a powerful nightmare, capable of summoning other nightmares. Riku learned that the two Traverse Town towns connected by the portal were not parallel worlds, but rather two distinct worlds that only felt the same. In other words, Riku was in a dream. Even though I don't get why, doesn't make sense, it's so confusing. Ugh, this game's plot. Anyway, he met up with Beat and Rhyme and let them defend the area while he raced after the powerful nightmare. But no sooner had he caught it than it escaped to the other Traverse Town. Beat and Rhyme were frustrated, but Riku assured them Sora would be able to handle things on the other side. They pledged to meet again one day, and Riku unlocked the sleeping keyhole. Oh, there's more? Okay. Meanwhile, in another world, Axel was dreaming of his best friend Roxas, and a promise he had made. Lee woke up and looked at himself in the mirror. He was a real person again. There were only four others there in the Radiant Garden study. Dylan, Alias, Evan, and Ienzo. Lee wondered what had become of Brig and Isa. But a thorough search of the castle and Virions? Is that how you say it? And Verns. As I say it, turned up no other returnees. Alias assured him no one was outside the castle, and Ienzo rejected the idea of the missing members having reappeared in other worlds. Dylan Evan remained in unstable condition. Lee realized what he would have to do. Elsewhere, Kimiki and friends could not help but wonder how Sora and Riku were doing in their exam. Just then, a raven flew into the tower. It was carrying Queen Minnie's tiara and a letter, a message from Maleficent. She had kidnapped Minnie, and if Mickey ever wanted to see her again, he, Donald, and Goofy would have to return to Disney Castle. King Mickey and the others found themselves face to face with Maleficent and Pete, who had Minnie. Maleficent demanded the data for all worlds. Unable to strike, King Mickey braced himself for the end, but before Maleficent's magic could hit, a blazing chakram knocked it out of the air. In the commotion, Minnie used some magic of her own to free herself from Pete. Having lost the upper hand, Maleficent and Pete made a hasty retreat. King Mickey turned to thank Axel, but the Chakron's red-haired owner corrected him. "My name is Lee," he said. "Got it memorized." Huh, alright. Oh, it's sort of the same long as two, huh. Alright, back in Jaffer's town, Sora bumped into a familiar face. Joshua told them that Nikku had found his partner, but they still hadn't made it back to their own world. To get there, they would need to have completed a mission. Sora raced to the rescue. He found Nikku and Shiki surrounded by nightmares, and convinced them to let him help, but it was no use. Once defeated, the nightmare's leader simply escaped to the other version of Traverse Town. Joshua returned and suggested they work with Riku and their friends in the other Traverse Town to trap the nightmare and take it down. Sora and his friends were ready when the nightmare resurfaced in their side of their town, but this time it escaped to another world entirely, somewhere not even Joshua could reach. Discouraged, Neku Chiki realized they had failed the mission, but Sora cheered them up by offering to take over where they had left off. After they pledged to meet again one day, Sora unlocked a sleeping keyhole. Okay, same thing. Yes, it did this. Yeah, okay. So basically the same thing at the bottom part, but for top it's different. Huh. Alright, whew, that was a lot of reading. But I'm glad it's done. Excuse me. So anyway, guys, so like I said, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And yeah, so this has been Hesitate to Cobra here. And oh yeah, like I said, this is gonna be the last episode, I guess, of recording this game. Cause after I upload this video, I'm gonna be recording Halo Wars 2. And then once I finish that game, then I will go back to this game. So, just a heads up, guys. Starting the next episode release is going to be Halo Wars 2, not Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance. But yeah, I hope you guys are prepared for that game, because I sure am. I can't wait to play it. I hope it's good. But we'll have to see how it goes, guys. So, yeah. So, see you guys then.